Hi everyone, welcome to another video of mine. Today we'll be discussing the Monarch Airlines shutdown in full. Although this happened late last year, I still believe it'd be interesting really to analyse not only Monarch as an airline, but what their fleet consisted of and ultimately how their downfall played out. This can be from the causes to what the sudden shutdown meant for passengers. We begin, however, with a look at Monarch Airlines more generally. Monarch Airlines was simply known to most as Monarch, and were a British carrier and scheduled low-cost airline. The airline's main base was at London Luton, however it had bases at Leeds Bradford, London Gatwick, Manchester Airport and Birmingham Airport. At the time of their closure, they operated to some 43 destinations. The airline was established by a pair of British businessmen all the way back in the year of 1976. However, it would take a further year for it to commence services, specifically the 5th of April 1968. They completed a charter flight from London Luton to Madrid, Spain, using the Bristol 175 Britannia 300 turboprop aircraft. A key to its growth were the travel packages that the airline offered. By 1972, the airline had carried 500,000 passengers in 1 year, and by the mid-70s, Monarch had finally moved to an all-jet airline. For the next 2 decades, Monarch absolutely dominated and continued to grow. It also acquired new aircraft like the 737s and A320s. They commenced services to Malaga and Tenerife and continued to spread their brand around the world. However, it was in the late 1990s that Monarch started to come under competition from a new threat, that being the newly emerging low-cost carriers, or otherwise referred to as budget airlines. Today, these budget airlines take a large part of the market not only in Europe, but also throughout Asia, Australia, America, and so on. When it comes to talking about an airline's downfall, it's never pleasant. While a number of people look instantly at the loss of a particular livery that they loved while spotting, it's also important to look at the people impacted by the situation, including the thousands that were displaced due to the loss of jobs, and the hundreds of thousands that had to adjust their bookings, and the 100 plus thousand that were stranded at their destination. At the time of Monarch shutting down, they operated the A320, A321, one Boeing 737 which was leased from Pegasus Airlines, and finally the Boeing 737 MAX which they had on order. However, that was of course never delivered. A screenshot of their current fleet, well I guess you could say past fleet now, will be on your screen. The airline also had quite a large historical fleet. Another screenshot is on your screen now. Obviously, the shutdown is why I think a lot of you would have come to this video, so let's get onto that now. The airline Monarch had in fact been struggling for some years leading up to the shutdown. It was kept aloft in 2014 through pay cuts and redundancies when taken over by the investment from Grey Bull Capital. However, the EU referendum and associated fall in the pound was one of the largest blows for the airline. The decline in sterling left Monarch paying some £50 million a year more for its fuel and aircraft. However, more broadly, British holidaymakers were deterred from travelling by the weak pound, and as a result, fares fell. The uncertainty around Brexit, including the fundamental question whether British carriers would still have the right to operate freely in Europe, also deterred potential buyers from rescuing the airline that was Monarch. Another major issue was terrorism. The carrier is known for being, above all, a leisure airline, operating routes to the Red Sea. This is one of its key markets. The route to Sharm el-Sheikh, I know I probably butchered that name, was one of Monarch's biggest and was stopped after 2015 when the bombing of a Russian Metrojet airliner occurred. Monarch also had to stop operating services to Tunisia after the shootings at Sousse in 2015. Obviously, with Monarch having a sizable fleet, one of the biggest positives coming from their shutdown for rival airlines were the multiple number of slots that opened up to airports like Gatwick, with airlines like EasyJet pouncing on the opportunity to gain more slots into an airport that they liked. On September the 25th, 2016, online rumours surfaced heavily about Monarch Airlines' imminent bankruptcy, which the airline strongly denied. What was even more interesting was the fact the Civil Aviation Authority had commenced sending spare planes from the other airlines to potentially help British citizens at short notice. In the following days, Monarch luckily obtained additional funds from shareholders. However, from then it just went downhill. And a year after the bankruptcy scare, more reports emerged saying Monarch were facing more issues with their license. Once again, similar to what happened in 2016, the Civil Aviation Authority obtained 10 airplanes from Qatar Airways. During the 1st of October, the airline's late-night flights to Ibiza were cancelled at the boarding stage as deadline for its license loomed. On the following morning, the airline's final flight, ZB3785, from Tel Aviv to Manchester, landed, and shortly after, the CAA confirmed Monarch Airlines had ceased operations with immediate effect and had entered administration, along with sister companies Monarch Holidays, First Aviation, Avro Limited, and Somewhere to Stay. This left 110,000 passengers overseas stranded. A total of 38 aircraft were chartered to help fix the problems as well. There are a number of fantastic videos online which show the incredible movements airports around England managed to see as a replacement for the Monarch aircraft, so feel free to browse YouTube for them. And that is the story of Monarch Airlines, the largest airline to have ever ceased trading in the UK. While this was a sad story for many, I hope you still enjoyed the video. I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.